Hi guys, I'm here playing The Division 2. It's a really good game, and I've been playing it with the Steam controller. I've been making Steam controller settings. I had a really good settings that I liked in The Division 1, but for some reason, like later on in the patches for that game, like my bindings that were like a mix of gamepad and keyboard settings were just not working properly. I'd press like one button and it would activate multiple buttons instead of the one button that was binded. It was strange and it wasn't working right. So I copied that same settings to start for this game, and the same issues kept popping up. So I just decided to go full keyboard and mouse for this. I know a lot of people like to have the right prompts show up, but I'm okay with learning the prompts. It only takes me a little bit to get used to the keyboard prompts that pop up, and I haven't had issues with this full keyboard and mouse setting control wise, so it's a lot better for me. I got the gyro aim, the mouse aim on the pad. It's very great in this game to be able to use these. Oh. Another enemy around here.
Hostile control point nearby.
I don't know where that came from. Anyway, so yeah, I did full keyboard and mouse in this game instead of a mix, and just avoid any kind of weird issues possible. But for the most part, I follow the same type of controls that are on the consoles, so most of it is similar. Anyway, it's just using the keyboard bindings. The big thing I have is the touch menu. I love the touch menu that I had in the first game, and I brought it back in this game. I changed some of the things because keybinds are different in this game, and I found there's some other things I wanted to put in here instead of what I had before. I have the way to switch weapons on the touch menu. I used to use this all the time in the first game. I would just go on the menu and directly select what weapon I want. It works well, but in this game I have been getting used to just using the Y button, just like on the consoles, the same way they do. I set up the bindings to work just like that, where you tap the Y button to swap between your weapons, so I don't have to use the touch menu. I still left the option there to use it to switch weapons directly, but I've just been using the Y button, and it works great. That's how I have it set up. If you hold the Y button in, you switch to your sidearm. So just tap it, switch your main weapons, and then hold it in to bring the sidearm out. That works great. The touch menu is good though. It has the armor kit. Well, I still have the same med kit from the first game, but it's an armor kit in this game. Grenade, just tap that in with the left touchpad, and you pull out your grenade. And you can just cancel it, or you can just aim and that'll cancel it too. Show scoreboard is something I put in here. These bottom ones are kind of just extra stuff. I was just figuring out what I wanted to put in here. Show scoreboard is a binding. I guess it'd be useful in PvP. I haven't played any PvP yet, but I put it there so I can see the scoreboard. Cut rope is in the dark zone. I haven't done any dark zone, but if you would cut the rope so that someone can't get their loot out, this button would be what you need to press, so I have that there. And also when you see other people around in the world here that you can view their stats and stuff, you would press this to view them. Go rogue is a binding. I guess in the dark zone you could just press the button and go rogue automatically instead of having to attack someone first, so I put that binding there just to have it. Auto run is here. If I just wanted to go pretty far, straight direction, I could just toggle auto run. Now he's moving automatically without me touching the left stick at all. Once I move the left stick, it turns off the auto run. But if you want to just automatically run, it's pretty helpful. So you know you're going to be running for far. Now I'm just using my right thumb to direct where he's going, but I'm not touching the left thumbstick at all. I'm just letting him run wherever he wants to go, wherever I want to go. And I don't have to hold the stick forward to be doing it. And then I could just cancel right out of it. And that works perfectly fine. And then this is for viewing a lot of the monuments you come up to in the game will pop up. And it says H to view the monument. So you can do that here. And you do. And then inventory. Instead of just like in the consoles where you open this menu here and then go into character to get into your inventory with this fancy bindings on the touch menu, I can just go straight to the inventory just like you would on the keyboard. If you wanted to, you could just press the key bind and it works just like that. Just go straight into the inventory, just a little bit faster. And then the med kit I showed, you would hold that in for the armor kit. And then the map, right when you touch the left touchpad, you just press it in and you get the map. So that's pretty useful. So I have 13 bindings here just on the left touchpad. It's super useful to have this touch menu on the Steam controller. It's really great. Works great in this game. There's a lot of use for it in this game. This last one here is the chat. I don't have the chat turned on, but even that I can do with the controller here instead of having to have a keyboard nearby or anything like that. I can just turn on the chat window here. And you can see the chat there. If I want to type into the chat, I just press this to open the chat. And then when I press it again, it'll bring up the keyboard. Well, it should. Seems kind of laggy right now with the keyboard. But yeah, I'd be able to type using the controller. Let me see if it works better. Enter keyboard. There we go. Now I have the keyboard available, both touchpads. I can say, hey, type it in, press done. And then I just press this button again, keyboard, to enter what I typed. Kind of messed up there and opened the keyboard again, but it should enter it like that. The reason it's messing up is the Steam overlay is being kind of laggy right now, so sometimes the game just kind of isn't liking having the Steam overlay popping up. Other times it's faster, but you can see what I typed did actually go through. So you can type on the controller just like with anything else. Scroll wheel here, I have it when I hold the left grip in, turns the left touchpad into a scroll wheel. It's super useful. So I can just scroll up and down this chat if I want to. In the inventory I can do that to see like weapon stats. Scroll up and down. Works very naturally. So yeah, chat works. I just usually turn it off, but it does work with the controller. You can do it if you wanted to. And then you can just exit out of that. And I'm gonna go ahead and turn that off, since I never really have a use for that. I never use chat anyway. So I'll just turn that off. So that's the entire touch menu I have for the gameplay. But what I did with this configuration was I put a menus action set, so when it goes into the menus, some of these settings actually change. The touch menu changes, like all the buttons are the same, but the way the game works is this key bindings do different things while you're in the menus, so this touch menu will also change to show that the actions that they're doing are different. So G would be for grenades, but when I'm in the menu, it's for comparing and to matchmake. V for the medkit is now it's marked as junk and toggle weapon. So it's the same exact touch menu, but when I'm in the menu, it pops up differently. So this is in gameplay. And then when I pause, go into the menu here, now this is the other touch menu. It's still on the left touchpad. But it detects that I'm in the menus now, and it changes. So I kept these weapon ones. They're useless in the menus, but I didn't really see anything to change them to, so I just left them there. Same with the scoreboard one, but these other ones I did change. The keyboard brings up the keyboard. Marcus junk will be right here, so if I want to mark something as junk, it's the same button where the medkit would be in gameplay, but now it's Marcus junk. Deconstructing is holding in the select button, so I'll deconstruct that. Favorite, I could favorite something. I put it on Y for favoriting and unfavoriting because I don't need to be switching weapons with Y when I'm in the menus, so now it's just on the Y button to favorite. And then of course I can compare. Like I said, I can compare things. Normalization is toggle the normalized stats, so you could see what the weapons would do, like in the PvP. How would I check that? You can check normalized stats to see how it would be when it's not leveled. It's just like a normal weapon for, like, in a competitive PvP match, they can normalize stats. I forgot where to check that, but it is in here somewhere in the menu. Maybe if I mod it. Yeah, if I mod it. So I tap that. Changes the stats. So right now it's just on my level 8 weapon. This is the stats for it. If I normalize it, this is what it would be in the, for anyone that uses this weapon in the normalized PvP. But I haven't tried that yet. But that's, you could check the stats for normalization. Loadouts, I have a delete loadout, and then this button H will take me to a loadout. So there's the loadouts by pressing H. And then if I wanted to delete this loadout, I can go right here and hold that in, and I would delete it. I can also overwrite with the Y button, go to options, F, which is on X. So I have literally everything covered in these settings. You're not going to find anything that doesn't work. I went through all the menus and made sure I was able to get through all the menus using my configuration here. So it's pretty nice. I love the aiming, the gyro. Just everything works well. Even in here, I can go through the tabs using the bumper, just like you would on the Xbox controller, PlayStation, just by using the bumper. Yeah, everything works. The grips I have for the movement-based abilities, so taking cover, I have it on the right grip. This feels very natural, just like I had in the first game. And I could just move cover to cover by holding in the right grip. And at the same time, I am moving the camera around, so I don't have to lose camera control to move cover. So I can just keep my thumb moving on the touchpad while cover to cover. Where if on a normal controller, you would have to take your thumb off the stick to press the button and then move your thumb back to the stick. But this whole time, I can be doing it while having full camera control. So that's really nice. Then the left grip is for climbing up onto things, so I can do that very naturally too. Without reaching my thumb anywhere, I can just grip the left grip and he jumps right over. Even though when I'm holding this left grip, it changes the left touchpad into a scroll wheel, but that really hasn't caused any problems. There's no time where I need to use this touch menu and then I also need to hold the left grip. That pretty much never comes up. I've never had it come up, so it really doesn't interfere at all, so it's very nice. You have the touch menu when you need it. When you open the menu, touch menu changes for the menus. The skills work on the bumpers, just like on a console controller. Just the left bumper brings up this Q skill, and then if I press the right bumper, I use my E skill. So everything works properly. I haven't had any problems, and the game has been a ton of fun, especially having mouse aim and gyro aim. it's super satisfying, the combat. Really recommend if anyone wants to try them out. Try out my settings. Oh yeah, I remember. There's one thing I was forgetting, is this emote wheel that I made. I got these number icons custom from a website. I'll put the link in the description. Because the Steam default icons does not have any numbers, which is very strange that they didn't put any numbers in. So I was looking for ones just for the emotes. And you would have to go into the key bindings for this. This is the only key mapping that I changed. So if you were using my settings, you'd put emote 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on numpad 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then that would have this wheel on right pad click is activated. So when you press the right pad in, it doesn't do anything. This middle binding doesn't do anything. So if you accidentally press it while in combat or anything, you're not going to accidentally start emoting. It doesn't do anything. But if you want to do an emote, you hold the right pad in and then move it up to do an emote. Move it to any of these emotes, they activate as soon as you highlight them, is how I set it up. There you go, I have 6 emotes that are quick access. And then I also put these blank bindings here just to separate this walk run setting. So if you want to walk around slowly, you can put on walk. So I'm pushing the left stick fully right now and I'm walking. So if you want to just like admire the environment and walk slowly, you can do that. And then you can just click in the right touchpad and highlight it again, and now you're back to the normal movement. So literally have everything that I could want with the key bindings. I found a way to put it in this configuration. Walking around, I like to do it sometimes. I just want to walk around and take everything in. I can do that with the right touchpad. So I'm in the middle of sprinting, but now I'm walking. And then I can just put it back on the run. I got my emotes. That's pretty much everything with these settings. I'll be uploading them to this straight Division 2 titled game community on Steam, but I'll also be posting the link in the description, so you can just copy and paste the link directly if you want to, directly into your browser, and it'll take you directly to Steam to apply it when you do that. So I'll post that link there too. And for these icons, there'll be a link there to get them for yourselves if you need custom icons for Steam. I'll also post a video that explains how to put custom icons, because I haven't explained that. And there's a good video I've watched that shows how to do all that. So you can do it also. You can choose different icons if you don't like the ones I have. But if you like to try these settings, I hope you like the video. And I hope you try these settings and have a lot of fun playing this game with the Steam controller, just like I am. Alright, thank you for watching.